Unfortunately, the many forms of elder abuse include ones that could put mutual funds and retirement savings at risk. It's something the fund industry has been worried about for years and working on behalf of funds and their investors. There are exciting new developments that will help make these assets safer and more secure.
People who want to exploit, you know, an elderly person, they're going to go where the money is. So where's the money? It's in their investment accounts and particularly their mutual fund accounts. So it's something we have long been focused on. It's currently a focus of the SEC, protecting senior investors, and it's something that we're happy to partner with them to work on.
And there's been a breakthrough this year.
We got authority from the SEC that will enable mutual fund companies to protect senior investors from financial exploitation. And the way they can do that now, as a result of the relief we got from the SEC, is if they suspect that a financial transaction is the result of financial abuse or exploitation of a senior citizen, that mutual fund can delay paying out those redemption proceeds until they have a chance to investigate and make sure it's a legitimate transaction and it's not a fraudster trying to take advantage of the senior citizen.
That's a really positive step. What else are you looking at in this space as things move forward?
Well, so what the members are really focused on now that we have that relief is working together with us and with agencies that protect senior investors to identify red flags so members know when that call comes in, is it suspicious? Could this be a, you know, attempt at financial exploitation? Is it something that we do need to delay paying out the redemption proceeds? So we have a working group that's set up that's working with all of our members to identify instances that could be red flags demonstrating that there may be financial abuse or exploitation going on so we can protect the assets of the account before they ever leave the account.